Good morning. Today we are going to talk about the another house of Williamson family. Now before going ahead, let me tell you, by this time you might have understood. Now you know, when Williamson family came on this deserted island, earlier they were living in the tent, then they started living in the tree house. Right, means what was happening, it is the whatever the story we are seeing, it is not of one day. They were continuously go on living there, you know. That's why for around 6 months they were living in tent, then for around 6-7 months maybe they were living in the tree house, then they made the third house, which was a cave house, and maybe for some months or some years they were living in cave house. So in this way they were go on leading their life. They started living on the deserted island. Now during that time what happened, along with that we have seen some different things also, like they, you know, with the help of some of the trees, they made the utensils, they made spoons, utensils, the things which were useful for them. Then they with the help of some of the plants or the milk of that plant, they made their shoes and footwears, we can say in that way. Not only that, but they started growing vegetables, food grains and everything. Means in between what happened, they made some fields also, hai na, kheti badi karna bhi wahi pe unhone dheere karke start kar di. In this way their living was going on. Okay, so I hope you understand that in this way they were going on. Let us continue now. Now come to page number 8, second paragraph from the bottom. Now one day they found that one of the family's had been completely destroyed, and the cultivated fields around it had been trampled and ruined. As I told you, why I was telling you all these things, there were huge footmarks everywhere. Father saw massive damage to trees as well as many huge footprints, which he identified as belonging to an elephant herd. Now, why I was telling you all these things? What happened when they, in the due course of their life, they started living there and they made some fields, maybe for hunting purpose also. They discovered different things. And in that way they were leaving. Now in the next episode we can see the next house. Now what happened when they were leaving in the cave house, during that time they came to know, one day Williamson, maybe when he went to the fields, maybe they made some fields nearby that cave only, field, you know, kheti badi karna shuru kar diya. And in that field what he found, they made some huts also, so that during night time sometimes they can watch all these crops and it should not be damaged by the wild animals. So kuch huts wagaire bhi unhone wahan pe bana diye taki kuch jangli janwar usko nuksan na pahuncha sake, ya fir un log ko kabhi wahan rukna hai, rest karna hai to field ke andar hi rest kar sake, aisi kuch arrangement rahi hogi. So one day what happened, ek din kya ho gaya ki Williamson jab aise hi us kheti ki taraf, unki fields ki taraf chale gaye, what he found that the trees, unhone kuch ped vagaire lagaye the, all the trees were completely destroyed. Not only the trees but the huts they made to rest in the fields, that was also trampled completely. And Williamson very carefully observed all the things that what had happened there, and he came to know, he observed the footprints or footmarks. And after observing the footmarks, he came to know that these are the footmarks of elephant. And from that he comes to the conclusion that these whatever jitna bhi nuksan pahuncha hai, ye kisne pahuncha hai, so it was of elephant herd. And that is why the Williamson family decided he now they have to make some solution out of this, because at the end they were human beings and they cannot fight all the time with the animals with the help of the with their brain. And a wild animal like elephant, there it was not unke bas ki baat nahi thi, wo bhi unse lad paaye, aur isiliye unhone कुछ सोचा क्या सोचा द नेक्स्ट मॉर्निंग द फैमिली बिगिन टू डिजाइन न्यू डिफेंस टू डिस्करेज ऑल वाइल्ड एनिमल फ्रॉम एंटरिंग देयर कल्टिवेटेड लैंड्स एंड नेक्स्ट मॉर्निंग मे बी दैट नाइट दे विलियमसन एंड द फैमिली डिस्कस्ड ऑन दिस इशू कि हाउ दे कैन सेव ऑल देयर क्रॉप्स फ्रॉम द वाइल्ड एनिमल्स बिग वाइल्ड एनिमल्स लाइक एन एलिफेंट एंड आफ्टर डूइंग ऑल दिस डिस्कशन दे कम टू द कंक्लूजन दैट they will have to design new kind of fields which would not be destroyed by the elephants or other wild animals and for that what they decided entering into the land so they finalize their ideas about a new residence and they decided that next they have to make their residence at such place where they can look after their fields also at the same time they can live also understood and for this purpose what they decided to make new residence now which kind of residence this time they are going to build let us see rather than building a house on a cells which the elephants could knock down easily they would use four strong trees growing in a square near one another as a foundation This time they decided that they will build the house again again in the trees. Okay, how it should be? It should be it should be between the four trees. So, getting what I'm saying? Four trees in this is, for example, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, like four pillars. Four trees would be there, and on that four pillars, in between that, they will make the house which. Elephants would not be easily damaged and they would use four strong growing in a square near one another as a foundation the trees were of equal size approximately 12 feet apart thus they built another house and in that way clearly it is not given the description is not given but their rough idea was four trees would be there of equal size apart from each other at the distance of 12 feet In that four trees would they will use as their foundation and on that they will make their new house and from there they can make or they can watch their fields also in that way they made their another house also and this was their fourth house understood in this way what happened they were continuing continuously go on living the deserted island okay So 10 years passed, I am on page number 9 now, or the first link. The 10 years passed and the young boys were now young men and their parents were very proud. They called the island New Switzerland. Many adventures occurred over the years. Now one thing what we are seeing the different incidences that happened with them and how they cope up with that incidences, how they tackled the situation and how they were living. Okay, till now here it is given in that way. For that, till now we have seen that they made four houses. Okay, according to the situation and they were living in that different four houses. Means, for example, sometimes if rain would be there, so they may be living in a tree house. During winter, they may be living in a cave house. You know, in that way it was going on. And in this way, they passed 10 years. How many years they were living now on this island? 10 years. 10 साल से वो उसी island पे रहना शुरू कर दिया. And young boys now are young men. The Freeds, you know, four boys were there. Four children were there of young Williamson family. So all these small kids are grown up as a young man now after 10 years. Means maybe Freeds would be of 10 years now. He is of 20 years. You know, in this 10 years they are grown up. And the parents are very proud now Williamson and Elizabeth both were very much proud on their children because all that four children or four boys or basically all of them were very good and all the time they were helping and they were obeying the duties and obeying the orders of their parents and that's why both mother and father were very happy on them And now, because they are living there on this island for 10 years, they gave this island as a new Switzerland. They gave one new name to that island. And what was that name? It was New Switzerland. Kya naam rakha unhone? New Switzerland. And in 10 saalon mein, ek ke baad ek, they made different adventures. this book is full of adventures. That is why this is adventurous kind of novel. Understood? And in this way the things were going on. And now the turning point is coming in the story. In every story we know, based on this novel, some movies are also made. Right? So in every movie we see there is a turning point. Now the turning point of this novel is going to come, and that we are going to study tomorrow. Okay? Already I sent message on your WhatsApp group that your workbooks are available in Samarth Book Depot. So you have to tell your parents to go to Samarth Book Depot and collect your workbooks. Okay? So for today, let me stop here. Tomorrow we are going to see the next part, which is going to be very interesting. Now till now the part was somewhat boring, but now the exciting part is going to start. Okay, so have a good day for today. Thank you very much.